The West Midlands Safari Park has 130 species of animal and a workforce of knowledgeable and experienced keepers. One of its more famous is Mark O'Shea, a world-renowned herpetologist who has worked in more than 30 countries. He's currently looking for reptiles and amphibians at the park's sister reserve in Africa. The Safari Park's head warden is on his way to join Mark and find out what he's discovered so far.
Reptiles aren't really my field of expertise. I'm far more used to lions, elephant, rhino, hippo, giraffe and the bigger stuff, but I'm not really a creepy crawly man. But this really is Mark's field of expertise, so I'm very interested indeed to catch up with Mark and see what he's come up with.
The Safari Park Sister Reserve is 150 square miles of Namibian countryside that used to be four farms. Now it's a safari tourist destination with a luxury lodge and tented camp. Behind the scenes, researchers are studying the rhino and lion populations and for the last 2.5 weeks, some of the smaller inhabitants of the reserve, with Mark's assistance.
These are pretty little snakes. Hi, Bob. Yeah, there you go, mate. Yeah. Good flight?
Yeah. Yes, not too bad.
Shake this hand. Got the snake in this hand.
A little bush snake. Yeah. Come and see what else we've got. We've done rather well, actually.
I'm very pleased with the number of species. I mean, we've got turtles down there, frogs, small skinks, geckos, larger skinks, big avambo tree skinks, sand snakes, bush snakes, a number of other small snakes. All these are scorpions and centipedes. Got a python down here, I'll show you him in a minute. There's a boom slang over there covered up so it doesn't get too excitable. And chameleons.
You've been busy.
I should say we have. Yeah. We've been putting in the hours, believe me. Yeah.
One of the things that Ongava Research Centre is trying to do is to get a really improved understanding of all the layers of the ecosystem here. So we are looking at herbivores, we're looking at carnivores, we're looking at grasses, we look at all kinds of layers. Now, in order to do that, we don't have all the local expertise we need. So to look at specific species niches, we need to call in the experts. So we've had an opportunity here to call in Mark O'Shea from the UK, international herpetologist, to come and study the reptiles and amphibians for us. Mark's been with us for a couple of weeks now, and I have to say it's been a really exciting time. It's been a great opportunity to get hands-on with some of the animals that we usually only see in fleeting.
Let me show you this python we got. It's a quite nice southern African rock python. We have to weight the lid down, because even though it's not a large specimen, it's pretty strong.
Well, it's long enough.
Yeah, it's under 2 meters, but it's a lovely young female, very pale.
Yeah, she's beautiful.
She is very nice. She was quite angry when we caught her. You won't even believe where we got this.
Should I wash my hands afterwards?
And in actual fact, she was in a toilet, but fortunately, it hadn't been used. And I might take you over there and show you that afterwards, because you never know, there might yet be another one in there. Toilets are always good places to find snakes.
Yeah, she's absolutely beautiful, isn't
she? She is very nice, lovely specimen, very nice patterning and everything.
And is she going back in the toilet?
No, we won't put her back in the toilet. I promised the workers I would release her some distance away.
Finding all these animals requires a lot of time and patience. Every morning the research team heads off early in the hope of discovering another species.
It's not just a case of finding all the big snakes and lizards. There are a lot of burrowers, there are a lot of nocturnal species, secretive small reptiles and amphibians. And one of the techniques to capture those is called a drift fence, which is basically a line of plastic sheeting buried in the ground with pitfall traps, buckets in other words, at intervals. And in the night, we hope that some of these animals come out, walk along the fence and drop in the buckets. What we're going to do now is go out and check the buckets. We've got two of these fences set up. This is real African bush, and there are a lot of dangerous animals out here. There are lions out here, and they will sneak up on you while you're bending over examining the contents of a bucket. So we have to have a gun guard with us, and we've got France. He's keeping an eye on our backs. I'm checking these pitfall traps, these buckets, to see if anything's fallen in the night. I'm using forceps because if you just put your hand in, there could be scorpions, could be centipedes, potentially it could be venomous snakes, and that'd be foolish. And I just move the vegetation that we've brought in here as bedding and the sand to see if anything's fallen in. This being the dry season, and also the night's been cold of late, we haven't had a lot of activity on the fence, but you can still be hit lucky and you can find lizards and frogs and things in here. When you're doing a survey, it's very important to look at all sorts of different habitats. And this is Mopani woodland alongside a wetland area which the animals come to. And hopefully we might find something in the drift fence here.
We're very much looking forward to repeating this survey again at the start of the coming wet season, so we can get some sort of comparisons. Maybe some of the burrowers that are living under the surface now may be brought up to the surface by the rain. So hopefully over the coming months and years we'll get a broad picture of what the reptiles and amphibians look like on Ongava.
We check both drift fences every morning as early as possible. Some mornings we find something, some mornings we don't. This morning we drew a blank. But that's field work.
The traps have come up trumps on other days. Mark has already found 24 species of reptile and amphibian. One of his jobs is to get a good visual record of each animal.
Now this is my photographic set. Photography is a very important method of recording the species, documenting the species that we're finding. And I use this idea wherever I work. Because basically if you're photographing a coiled up snake in the wilds, if the snake decides it's going to run, you've got an option. You either dive after it to catch the snake and risk smashing the camera, or you put the camera down gently and risk losing the snake. This basically prevents that problem. If the snake wants to escape, it's got to go over me. This is a western bark snake, but in actual fact it's more associated with rocky outcrops, and it's a little back fang venomous snake that feeds on very small geckos, and it's perfectly harmless to us. It's got a lovely little viperine pattern down the back. Most scorpions aren't going to kill you, but as someone who's been stung twice by non-fatal species, it is painful and it's not something you want to have happen. See, I can do this with the burrowing scorpion. I have no intentions of doing it with the fat tail scorpion. The fat tails are the deadly ones. This big burrowing scorpion with his big claws is far less venomous, even though he's got a big sting, than this little lethal fat tail scorpion. Now, Namibia is a land of desert and semi-desert, and the last thing you'd expect to see are amphibians like frogs. But look at this fellow we caught digging in near a dam. This is a sand frog. What he's trying to do is get away from the aridity, away from the dryness. He's digging backwards, going underground, where he's going to survive the dry spell. He'll come out again when it rains. There are at least 3,000 species of lizards, and this is Turner's thick-toed gecko. And as you can see, he's regenerated a tail. Lots of lizards will break their tails off if they're grabbed by a predator, and the tail wiggles like a decapitated snake, attracting the predator's attention. Lizard runs away and gradually regrows a new tail. This turnip-shaped object. And if you want to know what the original tail is supposed to look like, I have one I made earlier here.